Good afternoon, everyone. I am Harshit, your tech host, and welcome to the Daily Tech News Bulletin brought to you by IT Voice. In today's news, we will be covering news about Department of Telecommunications combat fake call centers, government directives on social media platforms, YouTube introduces comment pausing feature, Amazon challenges FTC antitrust lawsuit, and more. To skip to any particular news story, use the chapters below. And don't forget to subscribe to IT Voice and stay up to date on all the latest tech news. The Department of Telecommunications DOT collaborates with law enforcement agencies LEAs and telecom service providers TSPs to combat the rise of fake call centers. Over the past 3 years, numerous illegal telecom setups have been unearthed, leading to reports of individuals being defrauded through these channels. DOT takes measures to block applications facilitating spoofed calls, preventing their availability on popular app stores. Citizen engagement promoted through the Sanchar Sathi portal enables reporting of international call with misleading Indian CLI. Verification of mobile connection help identify unauthorized subscriptions resulting in over 13 lakh disconnected connections. Approximately 55.52 lakh suspicious mobile connections identified and disconnected, with action against more than 70,000 SIM agents selling illicit connections. Proactive AI ML analysis by DOT targets entities sending SMS through distributed ledger technology DLT platform, leading to removal of thousands of principal entities, PEs, SMS headers, and content templates. Minister of State for Electronics and Information Technology Rajiv Chandrasekhar reveals startling figures on government directives to major social media platforms during the ongoing parliamentary session. Significant volume of orders issued over the last 5 years underscores government interventions for national security, public order, and sovereignty maintenance. Directions target platforms including Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, X Corporation, YouTube, and others. Zero tolerance policy towards cybercrime prompts notices to social media intermediaries, including Telegram, YouTube, and X, to remove or disable access to child sexual abuse material, CSAM, and related groups. Platforms urged to implement proactive measures like content moderation algorithms and reporting mechanisms to prevent CSAM dissemination. YouTube introduces a new feature allowing creators to pause comments without deleting existing ones. Users can see previously posted comment but won't be able to add new ones, providing flexibility in comment moderation. Creators can select pause and video level comment setting found in the YouTube app or studio on desktop or mobile. This feature simplifies comment management, allowing creators a break from moderating comment without disabling the entire comment section. YouTube also implement new policies requiring creators to disclose alter or synthetic content produced with generative AI tools. iPhone users face a major security issue due to a loophole in Apple's test flight program. Hackers exploit the test flight loophole to push spyware through third-party keyboards used on iPhones. Certo Software, a UK-based cybersecurity firm, details these attacks, emphasizing lax test flight app policies enabling spying on users. Malicious third-party keyboard apps gain full access to iPhones, replacing the default keyboard and enabling keyloggers. Apple's inability to track these apps during the test flight process raises concern, prompting security recommendations for users. Amazon.com seeks dismissal of the US government antitrust lawsuit alleging illegal strategies to boost profits. The US Federal Trade Commission FTC accuses Amazon of using an algorithm, Project Nessie, allegedly increasing prices by over $1 billion. Amazon argues the FTC confused common retail practices with anti-competitive conduct falling to identify harm to consumers. In its motion to dismiss, Amazon asserts that Nessie was discontinued in 2019 and the company matches competitors' lowest prices. Amazon contends it competes with various online superstores like Walmart and Target, along with specialized market stores like Best Buy, Home Depot, Kroger, Costco, Staples, Walgreens, Nike, and Apple. The complaint's online superstore market concept is challenged as implausible, suggesting consumers wouldn't consider BestBuy.com for a low-priced TV just because Best Buy doesn't sell shoes. Next up, we have Google criticizes a potential European Union antitrust order to sell part of its ad tech business, deeming it disproportionate and unfavorable for advertising partners. Directors Oliver Bethel and Dan Taylor oppose divestment, claiming the remedy would be disproportionate. European Commission alleges Google abused dominance in online advertising technology since 2014. Google's advertising business, accounting for 79% of total revenue, makes the stakes higher in this clash with regulators. Google may request a closed hearing to present its case before senior European Union and national antitrust official. At last, Netflix co-CEO Ted Sarandos envisions scaling up the user base to 100 million subscribers in India. Despite a global user base of 247 million subscribers, Netflix has fewer than 10 million subscribers in India. Efforts to appeal to a wider audience in India include acquiring theatrical movies and adjusting pricing. Netflix focuses on increasing the value of offering, emphasizing a more mainstream product positioning. Content investment in India accelerate with plan to invest Rs 3000 crore in original Indian content over 2 years. Netflix global annual content budget of $17 billion in 2024 reflect a commitment to diverse and expensive programming. This is Harshit signing off. Stay tuned and follow IT Voice for the latest tech news. हेलो दोस्तों, क्या आपने अपने डिवाइस में कभी DCIM नाम का फोल्डर देखा है और सोचा है ये क्या होता है? DCIM का फुल फॉर्म है डिजिटल कैमरा इमेजेस। ये एक स्टैंडर्ड फोल्डर स्ट्रक्चर है जो आपके डिजिटल कैमरा या स्मार्टफोन से ली गई फोटोज और वीडियोस को स्टोर करता है। तो अगली बार जब आप अपनी फाइल्स को ब्राउज करेंगे तो आपको पता होगा DCIM का क्या मतलब होता है। सब्सक्राइब बटन को क्लिक करना मत भूलना फॉर मोर टेक इनसाइट्स। मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट शॉर्ट।